Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. In this class, you are going to learn about the security module that is available within Scriptcase. Scriptcase offers a complete security generator, which can create all the pages and functions required for various types of security requirements, which can be added to your project within a few straightforward steps. It creates complete access control with restrictions according to the system, users, and groups, depending on the selection, as there are a few options to pick from. Scriptcase will create all the database tables and applications that are required for it to manage the system security according to the security type that is applied. Scriptcase has four types of security: user security, application security, group security, and also LDAP security. For the user security type, all users have access to all applications. It is designed for single user authentication. Scriptcase will create one table to store the username and password information and validates the user access using a login screen. In this security type, Scriptcase creates the following tables. The fields of this table are login, password, name, email, active, activation code, and admin privileges. The next table would be called the logged users. It will store the login, being the username, the login date, session, and IP address of the logged users. But it is only created if the option Protect Logged Users is being used within the security module. The application security type will also create the same username and password login authentication control, but it also creates a restricted access control to the applications or system options according to the logged in user account. With this type, it is possible to define which applications are accessible on a per-user basis. For the application security type, Scriptcase creates the following tables. The user table, where it stores again the login name, password, the username, email, active, activation code, and if the user has admin privileges. It also includes then the application table. Now this table is to store the code, description, and type of the applications. And then the user/application table, which is where the relations between user and applications are stored. And it keeps which privileges each user has per application, such as access, insert, delete, and update privileges. And it could also include export or print for reports. Another table is then the logged users, which is also similar to the user security type. The group security includes the same options as the user and application security types. However, with the group security type, you will group the users and define the permissions to access the applications or system options according to the groups. One user can belong to one or more groups, for instance. It creates the same user and application tables of the previous security types we had discussed a few moments ago. But now with the group security, there are three more tables. There is also the group table, which contains the description and ID of the group. The user group table, which contains which group each user belongs to. And then the group application table, which stores the relationships between groups and applications, and is also where it keeps which privileges each group of user has per application, being access, insert, delete, and update privileges, and again could also include the export and print options for reports. The Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, or LDAP, is an open vendor neutral industry standard application protocol for accessing and maintaining distributed directory information services over an IP network or Internet Protocol Network. You can use this protocol within Scriptcase security modules to authenticate users in two possible ways. Authentication only performs only a simple user authentication, similar to the standard user security type and the total control, where you can define the access by groups similar to the group security type. In this security type, Scriptcase creates the same tables as the application security type. So now let's go ahead and create a security module by using the group security type, since it is the most used within Scriptcase. Okay, so first of all, within Scriptcase, we need to access the top menu And there we have modules and then security. Clicking that will present us with the security module options where we can begin to create the security system for our project. Now, the first option I have presented is to use a profile. These are profiles which can be saved and then used later. Once you've completed the setup of your security system within Scriptcase, you have the option to save the setup that you have applied, and then it will be displayed here within the Use Profile drop-down menu. For now, I will go ahead, select the Create New, and go ahead and click the Next button. Now here I need to select the security type, which is then Group, and again I will go ahead and click the Next button. So after the security type definition, I need to indicate the connection that will be used to create the tables that make up the security module. So here I will use the connection fundamentals, which is the same connection I have been using throughout this training for all of the current applications. So all of the connections that have been created within the project will then also be displayed for selection. The radio button down below will let us choose if we want to use existing tables in the database, or if you want to create brand new tables. Since I do not have any of the security tables within the database, I will go ahead and select the Create Tables, and then below that I have the option of setting a table prefix, which will be used within the database. This will allow us to identify the relevant tables for the security system. Below that I have three checkboxes, one which allows me to delete the tables if they already exist. So I'm just going to go ahead and select that. And then I have the option to protect logged in users, meaning if you logged in on another computer and you didn't log out, and then after you try to log in with the same username on another computer, the security platform will provide the user with a message alerting them that they are still logged in somewhere else. It will also ask the user if they want to force a log off, allowing the user then to log in again. Scriptcase also has an option to use social media as a login. So I will be using social media for this example. If you want to find out more about that, there is plenty of content within our website. Please go ahead and watch some of those, and you'll see also how to set up a social security system. So I'm going to go ahead and click the next button. And as you can see now, all of our tables have been created. We then also have a success log telling us that everything is okay. We can then view the SQL used, which then scrolling down, we have then all of the tables, and we can also download the SQL if we so choose. So I'm going to go ahead and go close. So as I selected the option to create the table, I do not need to define any links to the relevant table fields here. And as you can see, the fields here are currently disabled, and selecting any of these will also all be disabled as all tables were created. So I'm going to go ahead and click the next button. So now here I can define some important settings for the security module. For the application's prefix, I can define a prefix for the applications that will be created automatically by the security module. The next setting allows you to specify what happens when the session expires. We have the three options: no action. In this case, Scriptcase will allow the end user to continue using the application. However, nothing after this session ends will be saved, which is very important to note. We then also have redirect to login after the session expires. This option will return the user back to the login screen and essentially logging them out once the session has expired. The final option is display a message that the session has expired. And this option will show a message saying that the session has expired, and after that, it redirects the user back to the login page again. The next setting here is used to select the encryption that is applied to store the user passwords within the user table. Available is MD5, SHA-1, SHA-256, and SHA-512. The next setting activates the application security flag of all project applications. This would automatically enable security for all applications which have been created. So this is again important to note. If you create new applications after the security module has been created, then you will need to enable the security flag within those applications manually. The next option activates the capture for the login application. So here we have the option no, capture, and also recapture. The capture option uses the built-in Scriptcase library for capture display, and also the recapture option which uses the Google's Recapture version 2. For this option, you will need to configure its API with Google in order for it to work correctly. Below that, you can then define the folder name that will be created to store the applications generated within the Scriptcase platform. And in the next option, you can define the theme that will be used for the applications created by the security module. The log option is also available if the project has a log module previously created. Below that, we can select the menu application. Now here we have two menus. We have a menu and also a tree menu available. Selecting one of these will insert the security links within the menu. Alternatively, we can create a menu application which will include all relevant links for the security platform. Below that, we can select the type of menu that we want to create, if it is a tree menu or a standard vertical horizontal menu. So let's access the next screen of options, which is then login. Within the login options, you can set the allowed characters as well as the amount of characters allowed for the username and password fields that are displayed within the login application. In the next screen, Retrieve Password, you can select the way the user needs to recover their password. These password recovery options work only when the SMTP server is configured properly. You will see that as we continue. The first password recovery option is to send email with the password. This option will only work if no encryption was selected for the end user. The next option is to reset the password and send it to the user's registered email address. This option will send an email which includes a link for the user, which essentially links them to an application within your project or platform, where they will then be able to provide a new password. The next option is to reset the password and send it to the user's registered email address. This will basically generate a new password for them. These password recovery options work only when the SMTP server is configured properly. And you will see that as we continue. Let's see the next screen, new users. So here we have some further options available. And here we can select if to allow the creation of new users. This will essentially provide front-end user creation abilities. You can also select if new users require activation by email and if the admin should be notified of a new user creation. It is important to note that the admin notifications require the SMTP to be configured and work correctly. At the bottom, you can change the default group name. Let's call this Department X. Okay, so then next is the email settings. And here you will need to provide the fields to enable the admin notifications. Here you can provide the SMTP server, being the host name, which could be scriptcase.net or mail.scriptcase.net, for example. The port you can use, 465, being SSL, 587 for TLS, or 25 for an unsafe connection. If you do not provide the port, Scriptcase will use the port 25 by default, being the unsecure connection. And let's not forget the SMTP username and password, as well as the SMTP outgoing email address that you want to use for all emails being sent by the platform. So the next up is then the logged users. On the logged users page settings, we can select here to display logged in users. This will create an extra application where we can view a list of logged in users within your platform. Below that, you have the brute force attack protection. And below that, we have the protection period, which is essentially the timeout. During an attack on the website or an attempt to log in multiple times and the incorrect details are provided, after so many retries, which is indicated below the lockout time, will then essentially lock out the user for the time specified here. This will ensure an extra level of security for your platform. The final page available is the login template. This is where you can use your own created template instead of the Scriptcase default form layout. To do this, you need to select yes, make sure you enable the external libraries, and then select the library you want to use from the drop-down menu. And during this training, we have used the samples, and we also replicated the samples and saved it within the project folder. Now here we have both of these options available, where here, for instance, I could select to use a login template, which is available within the samples that we stored previously. For more information and guides on creating custom forms using the Control application, do also please check our website for upcoming webinars and or information. Now clicking next here, we can then set the first user information, which is essentially the admin account. This information will be inserted into the security tables, as well as the admin group, which is indicated here. We can change the admin group name if we so choose. We can provide the admin email address, as well as specify a username and password, and the admin name, which can of course be admin, or the actual name of the admin user. Once you're ready, we can go ahead and click the next button again. Now here we can select to add all current applications to the table applications for group access configuration. So let's continue and click next, and then we are presented with the final step. For this final step, you can save or store all settings you have selected during the creation process, so you can use them later within other projects. And at the beginning of this video, we had seen that there was the option to use a profile, which is where this then essentially comes from. But then we can go ahead and click the generate security. Now that you have created a security module for this project, it will automatically enable security for available applications with it. And when you have the security option enabled for an application and then try to access it without logging in, let's see what will happen. So let's go ahead and generate our source code. Now once the source code has been generated, we can go ahead and close, meaning that our security platform is now fully created. And we can already see the initial applications here, which is also within the security folder, which we had selected to create. So now if I go ahead and run, say for instance, the form edit users, and then when running the application, you will receive such an error message saying that it is an unauthorized user. Now, sometimes it makes it harder to test the changes within the development environment once a security platform has been created. So what you can do is you can deactivate the security within the development environment by using the main menu setting. So let's go ahead and check that out. So back within Scriptcase, we have up here the options and then my Scriptcase. Now within my Scriptcase, you have the option enable use security checked. Deselecting this and then saving will give you the option to reload the Scriptcase platform. So I go ahead and do that. So now it takes me back to the applications again. And now if I go ahead and run the same form again, and now we will be able to see that the form runs perfectly fine and that the security is enabled when I then essentially deploy the applications. So let's return back to Scriptcase and access my Scriptcase again. Now do notice below the enable use of security that we also have the option enable use of password. This specific restriction is for the applications themselves. Enabling it would allow you to also add a password to individual applications, which can then be configured on a per application basis. For instance, if you have an application which you only want specific users access to, you can define a hard-coded password for that application. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.